Hey guys, it's Phoenix. Today I'm on 18W16A. I'm a little bit late to the party. Apparently there is a massive customization feature which I played around with during the live stream last night. If you guys haven't heard of it, it is the buffet mode. This is a new world generation mode or new game mode in Minecraft where you can essentially just harass the game. And this is perhaps going to be the replacement for what we've realized to be the world customization options, which we had before this snapshot. So you need to go over here and go to buffet mode and customize. Now, you only have two world generators right now, which is a little bit odd because apparently Nether works, but they haven't actually added that in. So we've got the End and the Overworld. The difference between these two is that the Overworld is just what we normally have, and the End is those End Islands. Obviously, this is kind of boring. Overworld is pretty boring, and if you do the Overworld and mix it with the End over here, nothing really happens. This is going to be stone with a few floaty End pillars, so it's not really that fascinating. So don't worry about the Overworld generator. I'm not going to show you guys what it is. The End is what has kind of driven people crazy, but again, there's really nothing fascinating about this. Now, I'm going to show you just what this looks like with the Plains biome, and I'm going to generate the world. Because this falls underneath the world generator options, you can actually physically change this yourself. Be that as it may, it's still very rudimentary, inchoate, so just be careful with it. It's going to prepare the spawn area, it's pretty slow, and you'll die. But I know that's going to I knew that was going to happen, so I saved myself. Anyway, it's going to go to spectator mode, and you can just see it's just the plains biome, but sort of generated like the End. So again, nothing crazy here. You can win in this game. So that's fun, that's fine. You have mineshafts, you have actual custom structures, and have a bit more fun with more customization abilities, because this is going to replace, as I would expect, the world customization options that we once had, which is really sad, because you had these really nice options, like Redstone Ready Worlds. That's going to be gone, I think. What I will show you is that you can actually find stuff. So we can have a village. So let's find a village here, and it's going to be up among this, very messy, convoluted mess, right? So you're going to have really funny structures here, but they will still spawn. I'm going to find a stronghold. I keep mistyping it. It's really weird. And let's go here. And here we go. So we have this. So we have a stronghold. So that's nice. So this is a fun challenge for you guys if you want, but you're just going to have one structure, one biome. But you can change this in the generator options, which I'll show you in a moment. Did I skip it? I may have skipped it. Here we go. So the Frozen Ocean is perhaps the best looking one for me. The reason for this is because you will have lava falls, and you'll have waterfalls, and you'll have icebergs, and you'll have actual land, and you'll have snakes of caves of water that will flow across each island. So like channels, like conduits. So you can have a lot of fun with this, and it looks really cool. And this will take a while because, it's kind of heavy on the game. So we'll take a minute here to just wait for this to generate, and I'll be right back. And here we go. All right, so you can just see what I'm talking about, right? For some reason, you will have lava lakes that spawn like this. I'm not sure why. I didn't expect Frozen Oceans to actually have lava because it's completely polarized. It's a little bit odd, doesn't make sense. It's, complete opposite of what you would expect. You'll have icebergs, which don't really spawn properly. They're almost like upside down. I'm guessing it's because the actual spike is impossible when you look at the End generator. You'll have moments where this is possible, but, it's not the usual. The problem here is you won't see any strongholds in an ocean-type biome. I'm not sure if this is a bug, but I'm pretty sure strongholds can spawn when you have oceans only. Now, I'm going to come over here, and every time I've done this, nothing appears. You'll just have an empty space, or land, or ocean ruins. Now, over here, we do actually have land, so that's the best scenario for a stronghold to spawn. I'm in spectator mode now, and look at that. No stronghold. You have mineshafts, which is great, but we want strongholds. Otherwise, this will never work. I love this. Anyway, so Frozen Ocean looks really nice. You guys can play around with this. And I will show you in a moment how to mesh together different biomes so you guys can have multiple biomes in the single world for buffet mode. It's pretty easy. You just need MBT Explorer or some MBT editing program and you can do it. So I just want to show you guys a couple more that, live stream people went mad over. I drove them up the wall. Apparently you guys really liked ice spikes. Not sure why. So this one's a lot quicker because it's really just land only, no water here. And you have actual ice spikes spawning. I'm pretty sure it's because these aren't actually custom structures. They're just part of, they're like trees. So if trees can spawn, maybe ice spikes can spawn. It's just my hypothesis. I'm probably wrong actually. Okay, let's do one more. I will pick the overworld generator here and let's do nether. So you have a nether biome inside an overworld generator. So you'll just have stone, very ordinary, but you will see pigment spawning, but you will see fortresses and ghasts, right? Because this is using the nether generator, which has the option to spawn the only structure possible, which is nether bridges, and we have them here. All right, so let's switch it up a little bit. I'm gonna show you guys something that I did off stream because this took a long time. I have combined multiple biomes and multiple generators. So we have a near spawn. I'm pretty sure I did an overworld structure, but that's totally fine. This is the end, and this is a nether structure. This is not possible in the current menu, but it is possible. So I don't know why they overlooked it. Maybe they weren't ready to release it, but it is completely possible to do so. So what I have here, what I've done instead is I've combined multiple different places. I am not in spectator mode, I can't tell. So we have a jungle inside a nether structure. This looks really pretty. So this showcases the full potential of this weird buffet game mode, right? So it's not precise, but it creates this mess that is so exciting and so unique and so risky that you can really enjoy playing Minecraft in this environment. Okay, so what you want is MBT Explorer. I'll leave a download link in the description if you guys are really interested in this. So this is the world that I created, and you need to go into level up dat, and in data, there is a generator option here. You want to double click this and just locate the two values that will be of your interest. Number one is the biome. So you want to know the code of this. You can look this up in the wiki. Again, I'll leave a link in the description for you guys. A ton of different biomes that you can add in. Frozen Ocean's my favorite. And chunk generator, you can do the underscore end, nether, or overworld. So nether is pretty cool, which is what I showed you guys. It has the roof of bedrock, and then it has the biomes inside. The end is those islands that you can see, and the overworld is just the overworld. It's pretty ordinary stuff. So you combine a lot of them. So what I'll do here is I'm actually in the world. I want to close out of this first. Okay, so I don't have to refresh. Nice. Minecraft : let's do roofed forest. And it updates immediately for every chunk that has not been generated yet. So let's do a roof forest inside a nether generated structure. Save it, jump back in, and load the world again. Oh, look at this. We have a shipwreck. And here we go. So we have the nether world structure. So you have those caves, those really weird caves inside the nether, and you have the bedrock at the top. Looks like we don't have any trees. I guess it's because trees don't spawn here. I saw jungle trees. Otherwise, this is kind of the potential of this. Definitely a lot more coming. They have made that very clear on their article, in their article. Leave a like, subscribe for more creative content, and big thank you to Agent M for talking me through this, some tips during the live stream. But again, the point that I'm trying to put across is, when is 1.13 coming out? Take care.